Assalamu alaikum guys. Today we are going to see physiological changes during pregnancy. It is a very interesting topic. Changes in vulva. It become edematous and hyperemic. Then labia minora, it become pigmented and hypertrophied. Vagina become hypertrophied, edematous and vascular. Because being vascular, it gives a bluish discoloration, which is called as Jacquemart's sign. And secretions, thin, copious and curdivite secretion is present. The glycogen is converted into lactic acid in the presence of lactobacillus, which prevents the growth of pathogenic microorganisms. Now we will see physiological changes that takes place in the uterus. Non-pregnant uterus is 50 gram and 7.5 cm in length. At term, it become 900 to 1000 gram and 35 cm in length. Then there occur hypertrophy and hyperplasia under the influence of estrogen and progesterone. There occur stretching of muscle. This is the normal muscle. The muscle stretches to this length. Then layers. The uterus is divided into three layers: outer, intermediate and inner. Outer longitudinal, inner crisscross, intermediate it is present in crisscross fashion in the form of 8. Then inner layer is have circular muscles. We can remember this O is present, is this first letter in the outer and second letter in the longitudinal. And in inner and circular, I is the first letter in inner and I is the second letter in the circular. Now shape. It is piriform in non-pregnant women. It becomes globular at 12 weeks, piriform at 28 weeks and spherical beyond 36 weeks. Normal antiverted position of the uterus become exaggerated at 8 weeks. Because it lies on the bladder, it exerts pressure on the bladder and there occurs increase in frequency. In later pregnancy, the uterus become erect. Now, Braxton Hicks contractions. Uterine contractions are named after Braxton Hicks, who first described it. These are spontaneous uterine contractions in early pregnancy. They are irregular, infrequent, spasmodic, painless, without any effect on dilation of the cervix. Near term, the contraction become frequent and intense and merge with painful uterine contraction. In abdominal pregnancy, Braxton Hicks contraction is not felt. Now, isthmus. It is connection between the cervix and the body. It is circularly arranged muscle fiber. It has sphincteric action. It retains the fetus. Incompetence of this sphincter leads to mid-trimester abortion. And treatment for this is encerclage operation. Then, changes in the cervix. There occur hypertrophy and hyperplasia of the connective tissue. There occurs increased vascularity that gives bluish discoloration. There occurs marked hypertrophy and hyperplasia of the gland, which leads to softening of the cervix. This is called as Goodell's sign. Secretion in the cervix become copious and tenacious under the influence of progesterone, which seals the cervical canal. Now, ovary. Corpus luteum, it secretes progesterone and estrogen under the influence of HCG, which is secreted by the placenta. And initially, it is secreted by the decidual cells of the initially, it is secreted by the syncytial trophoblast. Then regression of this corpus luteum occur following decline in the secretion of HCG from the placenta. Then corpus luteum maintain the environment for ovum before the action is taken over by the placenta. Then the hormone also inhibit ripening of follicles. Then changes in the breast. Changes in the breast are best evident in primae gravida. Changes in size. There occur marked hypertrophy and proliferation of duct under the influence of estrogen. And changes in the alveoli takes place under the influence of estrogen as well as progesterone. There occurs hypertrophy of the connective tissue stroma. Increased vascularity gives bluish vein under the skin presentation. Then axillary tail, it become enlarged and painful. Then nipple and areola, nipple become larger, erectile and deeply pigmented. Sebaceous gland in the areola become hypertrophied, which is called as Montgomery tubercles. Then secretion. At 12 weeks it is sticky, 16 week thick and yellowish, and demonstration of secretion from the breast of a woman who have never lactated is an important sign of pregnancy. Then cutaneous changes. There occurs chloesma gravidarum. In this chloesma gravidarum, there occurs pigmentation around the eyes, on the forehead, cheeks. Then changes in the breast we have seen earlier. Then abdomen, there occurs linea nigra. This is brownish line present from xiphoid process till the pubic symphysis. This line is produced under the influence of estrogen and progesterone. It can also be seen in women taking OC pills. Then stria gravidarum. What is this? These are depressed lines of variable length present on the abdomen, mainly of the abdomen. It can also be present on the breast and the inner thigh. It represents scar tissue in the deeper layer of cutis. Initially, it is pink and later it becomes white. When become white, it is called as stria albicans. Apart from stretching, increase in aldosterone is responsible factor. Then, how can we prevent this? By controlled weight gain and massaging the abdominal wall by lubricant like olive oil may be helpful in reducing its formation. Apart from pregnancy, it can also be seen in persons having edema, obesity and Cushing's syndrome. Then weight gain. In healthy women, weight gain is 11 kg. 1 kg in the first trimester, 5 kg in the second trimester, 5 kg in the third trimester. And rapid weight gain of 0.5 kg per week or 2 kg per month is an early manifestation of preeclampsia. Then stationary or falling weight. It indicates intrauterine growth retardation or death. Then ideal weight gain according to the pre-pregnant BMI. Females who have BMI 20 to 26 should gain weight from 11 to 16 kg. Then females who have BMI of more than 29 should not gain more than 7 kg. Then females who have BMI less than 19 should at least gain 18 kg. Then body water metabolism. Pregnancy is a state of hypervolemia. Active retention of sodium, potassium and water occur in pregnancy. Causes are changes in osmoregulation, there is increased thirst and water retention. Then increased estrogen and progesterone, increased renin angiotensin aldosterone system, then ADH in atrial natriuretic peptide. Then hematological changes. In pregnancy, blood volume is markedly raised. Plasma volume as well as RBC increases. Plasma volume increased by 50% and RBC and hemoglobin increases by 30%. Even though both raises, but the increase in plasma volume is much higher than the increase in the RBC and hemoglobin. This disproportionate increase in the RBC and plasma volume leads to hemodilution. What are the advantages of this hemodilution? There occurs diminished blood viscosity. It leads to optimum gas exchange. Then decrease affinity of maternal blood to O2. Per unit volume of blood, there is less RBC, less hemoglobin. So there is decreased affinity of maternal blood to oxygen. Then protection of mother against the adverse effect of blood loss. There occurs blood loss during delivery, so it is prevented. Then neutrophilic leukocytosis occur. Total protein increases, but due to hemodilution, protein concentration decreases. Albumin decrease, globulin increase. As a result, albumin to globulin ratio, which was initially 1.7:1, becomes 1:1. Blood coagulation factor. Pregnancy is hypercoagulable state. It is effective to control blood loss during delivery, but its adverse effects are it can lead to DVT.